Our ears allow us to enjoy the magic of music. But what happens when we hear an instrument played? What happens is that waves are created in the air that surrounds us, and these expanding ripples of pressure are the sound detected by our ears. Sound waves make the eardrum vibrate. The eardrum in turn transmits the signal to a tiny bone called the hammer, which beats on another bone known as the anvil. A third bone, the stirrup, passes on the amplified vibrations to the inner ear. Here we find the cochlea, and these ultra-sensitive hairs, the Corti organs, which tremble with every vibration. Sodium ion messengers swim about in a state of readiness. Inside the cell, there is much activity, just like the normal hustle and bustle we've seen in other cells. But when we penetrate the nucleus, we find a control room devoted to the measurement of sound.
Look, these are medium loud vibrations of about 80 decibels. Let's get them recorded. Polarize the cell. Let the sodium ion messengers in. They'll pass the signal on for us.
Huh? I can't hear anything. They told me I was assigned to a sound transmission unit.
That's absolutely right.
Why is it so quiet then?
Because we don't hear anything, you see. Our job is transmitting vibrations, their frequency, their amplitude, that's it.
I think I see what you mean. I suppose it must be the brain that turns the vibrations into sound.
Yes, that's where they do the hearing. Look at the screen. You can see the walls of the cell out there. Watch for the sodium ion messengers. Their job is to help the neurotransmitters.
All right, where to now?
I thought you knew.
What a shambles. Who's in charge?
I've got it, guys. The neurotransmitters are this way.
This way!
Come on, push harder. Some sodium ions don't pull their weight.
I'm not one of them.
Why don't you save your breath for pushing?
Look out, chaps, we're almost there. Unload the neurotransmitters for the auditory nerve.
That's how it's done. First of all, we register the vibrations, then pass them on as auditory nerve impulses to the brain.
So that's hearing, is it?
Not by a long chalk, my lad. You see, the signals we send can only be interpreted by the brain itself. And the messages we transmit have still got an awful long way to travel. The message is carried along the nerve cell until it reaches the nucleus with a control room very similar to our own. And when things are quiet outside the body, they're quiet inside it as well.
Right, this harmonic wave is only 65 decibels.
Speedy, your job is delivering messages, not reading them. Now take it to the 8th auditory nerve.
Hmm. Glovers in a hurry should be put away for life.
Look alive, men. Another message coming through.
Impulse runs up the nerve cell until it has to jump to the next cell at a junction. We see the message relayed from cell to cell along the auditory nerve. Finally, the impulse reaches the brain, where it's converted into the sound we hear.
Groove, Daddy-O, in the groove. Wonderful, isn't it? Simple sound vibrations, that's all they are, but when the ear has picked them up and the brain has processed them, they're pure magic. How the brain does it is a bit of a mystery, but what a marvel all the same.
Here, get moving. As I told you only yesterday, when I met Hannah in the plate.
Oh! I can always lead Henry nearest if he don't feel up to it.
You told the plate.
They say that music calms the savage breast, but personally I find it rather stimulating.
Professor Globus, lost your sea legs?
Is something bothering you, Lieutenant?
I've got a hunch that there's something very wrong in this section, Captain.
Well, your hunches are usually right. Lead the way, Lieutenant.
Professor Globus, what caused that earthquake?
We're on the eardrum, you see. Those three little bones, the hammer, the anvil, and the stirrup, may be the smallest bones in the body, but they amplify the vibrations 20 times.
Hurry up, men. We're almost there.
Hurry up. That's all very well, but here we are, climbing up a dark, slippery tunnel. We don't even know where we are.
I know where we are, numbskull. In the Eustachian tube. It links the nose to the ear, which is where we're headed.
Why the ear?
Let me tell you why. It's a nice, quiet place where we can creep in undetected. You lot are lucky to have a leader with brains like me. We're going to set up a beautiful otitis.
What's that?
You ignorant slob, you don't even know what otitis is. Idiot, otitis is an ear infection that young kids get all the time. Now, let's move along. Hold it. I don't like the look of that. Hide yourselves.
Take a look down there, Captain. Do you see them?
Yes, Lieutenant. Let's move in closer. Calling all antibody troops. Report immediately to right to station tube to repel large invasion force of Staphylococcus germs. I repeat, report to right to station tube to repel large invasion force of Staphylococcus germs.
Message received. We're on our way. Over and out.
Lucky to have a leader with brains, he said. We can keep it undetected, he said.
Mission accomplished, Captain. No problem. We're more than a match for those hulking great Staphylococcus thugs.
Yes, indeed, Metro. It looks as though we've nipped that one in the bud.
It's funny. I had a pain in my ear, but it's gone away now. You seem to be getting on quite well with your piano lessons. Are you finished now?
Mm-hmm. Why don't we go for a ride on our bikes?
Good idea. We can take a ride over to the park and back again.
Go for it, Stroppy. There's no cops in sight.
Hey!
The idiot. He could have got himself killed.
Signal flapping.
Because it's a very loud noise, 140 decibels. It's painful. We'd better send it through urgently.
Just a minute. We can't use normal channels for 140 decibel noise like that. What we need is a priority pain messenger.
Oh. Thanks.
What now, Chief?
So many pain signals at once, it's abnormal.
Could there be some mistake? Or do you think we should send a message to block the ears?
We can't take that sort of decision. It has to be handled upstairs. So let's get on and transmit those pain messages. Ours not to reason why, I'm afraid. Ours but to do our job. So let's get to work.
Got it.
Work like a slave and where does it get you, huh? While whippersnappers like him get promoted to the flying squad. I don't know. Or could it be a question of fashion? Is it the in thing to wear leathers and a helmet these days? That's it. Why on earth didn't I think of it earlier? Just watch me. I'm about to join the very latest fashion trend. Fooled him, didn't I? Huh. Hey?
Mr. Policeman, we'd be delighted to come forward as witnesses if you decide to prosecute those reckless children.
The lights were red.
The traffic lights were green, weren't they? Well, maybe they were amber, don't you agree, Stroppy?
And that's not all. Just how fast do you think you were going?
Well, we weren't speeding. We were doing 30 or 40 at the outside.
And your horn, it's a regulation hooter, I suppose, even though it's still ringing in my ears? Exceeding the speed limit, failing to stop at a red light, and using an illegal warning device? Now, what about your license? If you can't produce your license, you're really in hot water.
Be so quiet working down here, but now I can't stand it. I just can't stand it. The noise is driving me mad. Ah! I can't bear it much longer. It's driving me crazy. The noise is going to destroy me.
Not till you've dealt with all these signals, young man.
I can't take all that.
Now, what's going on here? What's this?
Thank you. You'd best be on your way. I'm not trying to make trouble, sir. It's just that I don't understand what's happening.
My dear young chap, sounds are only vibrations, and when the vibrations become too strong, they hurt. The pain is meant as a danger signal to warn us.
A danger signal?
Yes, it all goes back to the times of the cavemen. Of course, in those days, our hearing was much more acute. That was donkeys years ago. But sound is still a warning to us in modern times.
Peter!
I understand how sound could be a warning, sir, but where does the pain come in?
The pain tells you that your hearing is in danger.
Boing. 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 Boing.
You see, the receptor cells are fragile and noise can shatter them.
Boing. 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 Boing.
Nowadays, we know how to protect ourselves against harmful noise. But some of us don't know just how harmful it can be. There's quite a hearing loss already, I'm afraid. There's nothing we can do to bring it back, and he'll have to be very careful in the future.
What can he do, Doctor?
Lower volume for shorter periods, that's my advice. Too much noise causes stress and destroys the sensory cells in the ears. The damage can never be repaired. The hearing loss is permanent.
Message for the nervous system. Increase the rate of heartbeat immediately.
Message for the lymphatic nervous system. Constrict the capillaries.
Message for the endocrine glands. Increase secretion of adrenaline with immediate effect.
There you are.
Bye for now, young fellow. I'll talk to you again soon. Do you see how too much noise can affect your health? So do take good care of your ears.
Peter, why don't we have a slow race where the loser's the first one to lose their balance?
Okay, let's try.
Oh, foot's down. 1 point to me.
One all. It's not so easy going slow and trying to keep your balance.
How do we keep our balance? Well, here again we use our ears. It's our ears that help us maintain our balance. Or at least a very special part of the ears called the vestibular apparatus. Our old friend Professor Globus is taking some young corpuscles on a guided tour of the area. Why don't we join them?
In fact, balance is a sense in its own right, isn't it? And those are its semicircular canals.
Look, it's easy. I can balance.
Watch.
Hey, let go. Oh. Put me down, you big bully.
You see? How'd you like that?
Now, as I was saying before...
What caused that earthquake, Professor?
Must have been a movement of the head. Look. When the head moves, the sensory cells inside the canals can detect this movement.
A movement has been recorded. The head is tilted forward 15 degrees. Emit sodium ion messengers to activate neurotransmitters.
This report states that the field of vision has shifted lower down, sir.
I have a message from the neck muscles. The head is tilting slightly.
According to this message, pressure is increasing on the left knee joint.
Why won't you go in? Oh, that's better.
Thanks.
Urgent signals from the semicircular canals. The head is tilted 15 degrees forward.
I think you ought to turn the handlebars.
He should push down on the pedal instead.
In my opinion, he should shift forward in the saddle.
Now, I don't agree with that at all, Chief.
Enough of this chatter. Our job is to send those signals upstairs. He'll fall off his bike if we fall behind with our work. Now move!
The ear is the organ of hearing, but as we've just seen, that's not all. With the vestibular apparatus and its semicircular canals, the ear is also the organ of balance. Without our ears, we could never stand up, let alone ride a bike.